Side is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc. and NVX. Buy genuine Soundman iPad dash kits at soundman.co and find high-quality car audio equipment at nvx.com. We are also sponsored by U.S. Alternators, Down for Sound Shop, and Audio Control. Good morning. Is it rolling? Take a look at what we have here. This guy has a thunderous bird. He wants to put some frogs in his bird. These are audio frog tweeters. Look at them. Audio. P.S. Feel free to use this for online content. Well, shit, Devin. I will. Here's some audio frogs, if you guys ever heard of them. These are some high-end tweeters. Okay. Oh, we got some nice steel aluminum tweeter cups. Huh? Ooh, look at these little frogs, eh? Get a close-up of that frog. Chrome bezel, Havin. In my T-Bird, I put some Macintosh tweeters in there. I made a little tweeter ring, kind of like this, because it didn't have any. Ooh, look at this one. Ooh, look at that little tweeter ring. Getting close on the ring, camera boy. My son Kai, the camera boy, is here. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's kind of nice. The chrome edge isn't super tight against the edge of the tweeter ringular. So we're going to put these kind of in here. Aiming up at your facial unit. This is an old school trick for like stereo systems with just a right and a left and a subwoofer for a front stage. I learned this from Bob Morrow. He was a old stereo madman, mad scientist. He used to come to my dad's old shop and teach us stuff. He would always have a tweeters and mids and a subwoofer. Ooh-wee! I think he was an ARC rep at one time. He's the first person I've heard about Hertz audio back in the day. Okay, now let's take a look out here at my bird. Let me move this cart. Moving cart! Let's go take the bird for a rip. A rip a runeski. Okay, let's go take a look at this reference bird that I made. Just for times like this. I said to myself, I need an extra T-Bird for when people want to do a T-Bird project. I could have a T-Bird. Okay, look at what you guys did. You're not even coming over there to film my arm. All right, take a look at this bird. Okay, go on out, camera boy, and get a shot of the bird. This is a good driving height. Oh, it's on my foot. Just kidding. You just hit it up twice in the back, twice in the front. Ooh, bitch, she's ready to roll. Okay, let me open the door for camera boy. Ooh, that's a nice and low in the back, eh? Oh, the fucking door's closed. I got a button here. I got a button. Have a seat in there, camera boy. Now, when you're seating in there, take a look at that kick panel, eh? Ooh, look at that kick panel. Oh, shit. Look at that smooth swoop. Look at that smooth swoop of the gimbular. The gimbulizer. Let me close the groupie chain to hold the groupies out. Oh yeah, ooh, ooh. Oh, it was nice cruising the bird today.
Unlocking bird unit. Don't look at my code.
Oh, check out this sunroof, baby. You gotta turn these knobs like this. You give this handle a crankular and a close and then a pull and twist for optimum visual enjoyment. You slide her back.
Ooh! Bitch! What do you think of that? Sunroof action, baby.
Oh no, camera boy has to buckle.
Let's buckle up the camera boy. Come on. Come on, little buddy. Oh, don't hit the camera now with the belt now. What if we crash? Okay?
I don't want to get sued for child abuse.
What kind of stupid songs do we have on here?
Oh, yeah, we got some Will Smith. Let's play some Will Smith and go slap some people. Let's go slap somebody. Flip these like this. Yeah, bitch. Yeah. Drive it like this.
The groove slightly transformed. Just a bit of a break from the norm. Just a little something to break the monotony.
I want to sell the bird. Oh, I'm going to get copyright claims for playing Will Smith. How you doing, sir? Yuck. There's a couple things I want to do on the T-Bird. Just for pictures. I'm going to take some pictures of it and send it on her way. I keep telling people I'm going to sell it. No one came and ran down and bought it yet. Okay, now this is a vehicle with hydraulics. Okay? So it's not your ordinary type of vehicle. Like, what if you dump aside when you're driving? Oh, yeah! Can't do that. Kind of normal vehicle.
The way that people respond to summer madness. The weather is hot, girls are dressing less. They're checking out the fellas to tell them who's best. Riding around in your Jeep or your Benzos or in your Nissan.
Oh, we're going to get copyright flagged. Okay, let's get Will Smith off of here. Slap this. See if I have any Chris Rock. Shit on here. I don't have Wi-Fi on my pad. Alright, well. Well. Oh no, a guy's coming. This thing runs good. Kai wants to sell his car and keep this car. I was wishing I sold this when I was done. Because what I like to build it, I like to build the car. And I don't necessarily, they just end up sitting. I don't drive them. I just want to have my own personal, like, fun car. A daily driver. And then for YouTube, I just want to build one car at a time and sell it. Then maybe we can, like, trade up until we'll start with a Buick Regal. See if we can get up to a Lamborghini. Just chill. Don't complain, just chill. How am I supposed to sell this when you're scraping it on the floor? This thing rails hard. Motorhome. Okay, come on. We're supposed to be pulling it in so we can work on the kick panels. You guys are over here dicking around hitting switches in the parking lot.
What? Your car?
It's all busted up and old and abandoned. You abandon your vehicle? Okay, let me open the groupie chain. Okay,
kept everybody out. Oh yeah, it looks good all locked up. Yeah, I don't want to have a vehicle collection. Because, man, you got to fucking smog these turds. You got to register these turds. Insurance. You have to insure the turds if you want to drive them all the time. Or you could be illegal. You could illegally drive them. How am I going to do this? There's a trailer hitch back here. This is all fucked over. Can't even get in. And dude, having so many unfinished projects is hellacious, bro. It sucks. It's so stressful. I don't even know how I got myself into this. How'd I get in this deep? This all started with the free T-Bird that was supposed to be free, remember? For you. You did this.
See, that's why you should just give it to me.
Dude, you...
It'll return us back
to that's a whole different bird, dude. That's a whole different vehicle.
That was supposed to be my bird, you said.
I tried. Non-registerable. Taking the left down! Ooh. Ooh. Shit. Howdy, brother. Now get the lowness, okay? Can you get yourself out of here? Can you get yourself... Let me untangle you from the bird wing.
Gotta rub it on my face.
Whoa, what? Ring, ding, dong. Ring da ding 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 dong. Keep my dong ringing. Ring ding dong. Oh, this baby's fucking running swell, baby. So when I bought this, it had 36,000 miles on the papers. And we put a gauge cluster with 15,000. So we knocked some years off her. Ooh, look at that. Nice. Hey, how you doing?
Good,
how
about you?
Good. Back up and get it in the frame. Don't look at me. What are you looking at me for? Ooh, look at that whip action. Ooh. Let's hit some switches in it. Now, water when I dive, there's a... I need to reinforce this area right here. Oh, where's my hood release? See, I have so many cars, I can't even keep track of where the hood releases are. See, this like popped a spot weld off right here from where we cut. We cut here for the A-arm to come through. So I want to kind of lay a weld right here and here on the each side of the arm. Okay, now I'm going to let it down so you can see this, what happens with the hole. Don't get your head clanked on the hood now. Can you hold the thing over it? Can you get the gimbal action? Gimbal light. Now look at him.
You wouldn't even
he's pissed. Now he's getting mad. Ooh, look at that. See, that's the mod you need if you want to be world's lowest T-Bird. Shit. Get a shot of that chrome alternator, boy. Shit howdy. Shit howdy dick licker. Lick me a turd. The rag top is rag topping. I wouldn't mind building another one of these. Shit, I'll just keep selling birds. I'll just keep sending birds out the nest. Shit, this guy's building himself a bird. Okay, let's take a look at Devin's kick panels. Here, get a shot of the front suspension. Ooh, yeah, look at that in there. Don't stick the gimbal in there and cut the head off of the phone. How's that look, Oh, my foot, just kidding. Oh, what was that? Oh no, I blew a piece of audio frog foam. Oh, what's going on over here?
My huge pecs are really
His pecs sweaty. Are sweating, everybody. His pec-domaloids. His pec-dominals?
They're so big, they're muffin top over my belly.
You're muffin topping, dude. Okay, so look at what we have to do here. Oh, look, that's almost the same son of a bitch size, isn't it? I'm going to pop my kick panels out, sell them to him, and I don't have to do dick. Except they're purple. This fucking grayish purple bullshit. Okay. I don't want to take mine out, do I? Hell no. I'm going to end up fucking taking it out. We'll be doing two sets of kick panels. Now, keep in mind, we have to leave him some room for his frog to stick out the back. Where's my marker? Don't run into the door, camera boy!
I wasn't running.
Okay, now we better fucking put this chain up so someone can climb it. Hang on, you don't gotta follow me through this labyrinth of bullshit. Alright, whatever the fuck, I don't care what you do, camera boy. Shit outie. What? No. I don't care. What are you doing back there with that? You can't carry that jug around like that, dude. You're gonna be drinking and making gulp noises. Gulping noises. You're supposed to drink before the show starts. Do you think a professional camera boy drinks during camera action work? You're gonna spill on the camera. Spill. Okay, look at this, Steven Spielberg. These go right about here. Now, the height of her, are you fucking even filming the marker?
This is the only way you can see with your big ass fingers all up in the way.
Okay, let me do it this way, everybody. See, what we're going to do is we're going to get one kind of in there, trimmed, and then we're going to symmetricalize. Oh, yeah, that's fucking perfect. It'd be nice. See what I'm looking back here, too. That frog has got some girth to her, so I think I'm going to go a little bit higher than mine. All right, now we can't fuck this up. If we do it wrong, we're going to end up fucking up Devin's kick panel. And you know how much a set of T-Bird kick panels are at a time like this? 2022? Rare! Quit backing up, camera boy! I'm trying to give you the damn... There you go. Don't get a piece of plastic in your eye. Safety first, everybody. Now we're just going to kind of eyeball this here like this. Oh! Oops, wrong kick panel. Oh yeah, like this. I'm gonna go oval with it. I'm gonna go on the small side, like your mom's wiener. Oh, look at that, What do you think? You better not be yawning already, dude.
Already 20 minutes.
20 minutes is when you start yawning? Is that how I'm supposed to keep track of the time?
Every 20 minutes I yawn.
Cutting kick panel. Oh yeah, oops, too big. What do you think of that, brother? Look at that hole. That looks like a fucking frog hole, if you ask me. What do you get when you put a frog in a bird? No, nobody knows. Nobody. Did I dip my ring in? Or I popped it out a little bit? Probably want to pop it out as much as we can for the depth. The depthitude. Now what we want to do is get the front of the ring on first, glued into place. Look at this grinder someone gave me. I'm scuffing the outer perimeter.
Scuffing perimeter. Oh, yeah. Oh. Ooh.
All right, you son of a fat bitch. Son of a fat bitch. These are not symmetrical. Oh, let me give that a semi-trickle, huh? Okay, so what we're gonna do is line this up like this. From the bottom neath to the corner neath. Precisity. I'm just gonna mark this like this. All right.
Look at that, guys, huh? Look at that. That's gonna give me a reference hole. Look, and I can even further eyeball it like this. Ooh.
All right, look down here, get an eyeball's view. A bird's eye view. Get it? Bird?
Because of the Thunderbird.
Okay, enough bullshitting. Okay, this is on the small side. Like your mom's breasticles.
All right, holy breasticle Tuesday, huh? Shit howdy, brother.
Okay, now we gotta fucking aim this with precisity. I like these little fucking metal cups we have here. Okay, I'm gonna go. Okay, here's what we're gonna do.
Come on over, camera boy. Don't be shy.
Why don't you just buy a Thunderbird, dude?
It's possible.
We'll bag it. Honestly, if I were to buy a Thunderbird and drive it, I would just lower it, dude. I would just lower the fucking thing, low as shit.
You always hate on static life, Mike.
No, I'm talking about if you're actually going to drive it around, though. Because, like, hitting switches is fun, driving around, going to shows, or fucking Cars and Coffee or whatever. But, like...
That's more drivable than, like, slam static.
Yeah, but, like... It's not, like, trouble-free, like a factory vehicle. Nobody. Well, I mean, you need a reliable daily driver. Look at that.
Ooh, old, look at that.
When you're an old man like yourself.
Look what I did here. See how I built that up with a little cheesy ball of glue? Oh, bitch. Ooh. That looks pretty fucking good. Get a comparison. Needs to pop up a little bit more. You know what I'm gonna do? You know what I'm gonna utilize, everybody? Look at what I'm gonna utilize. I'm gonna go into my toolbox and utilize a pair of these around the back. We're going around the back with it. I'm gonna use my matting that I made. Remember that video? Remember that one video? Okay, quit dicking around. This comes in handy for times like this. Master Fabricator's like, yeah, I told you to go to my Instagram to see what I fabricate. Bitch, I ain't going to Instagram. I'm not gonna go on, download a bunch of bullshit. I don't spend all day on apps like you, Master Fabricator. You're dicking around, bullshit, and flipping Instagram, going to YouTube, Facebook, TikTok. He's got them all lined up, flipping and flapping.
Damn. Okay, come on over here so you can see what I'm doing.
You can see it.
So, Master Fabricator, you can just tell me what you do in the fucking box. Don't be ashamed that you don't have any YouTube videos. Don't be ashamed. Oh no, it's moving on me. She's moving on me. Just like Master Fabricator's lips. Oh, my thumb is stuck. Oh no. Okay. Okay, now look at this. Look what we have here. I'm gonna bend this and break it. Are you zooming in?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. That's good, camera boy. Look at, I made a stilting device. You see? You see this?
Upgrade your vehicle's charging system with a high-output alternator from U.S. Alternators. Visit usalternators.com. Down for Sound is an authorized dealer and offers the best prices on the brands they carry with the fastest shipping in the industry. Go to downforsoundshop.com. Audio Control has what you need to make your good stereo system sound better. Take a look at Audio Control's full line of equalizers, line drivers, digital signal processors, and more at audiocontrol.com.
Okay, tell your stories if you've ever gotten CA glue and then accelerator on your finger and burned your hand off. Oh, you piece of fucking turd shit. Can I help you? It fell off, guys. See, this is the trouble when you're fabricating. The glue sticks to the ring material quite swell. What do you say, camera boy, hmm?
I don't give a damn.
He doesn't give a damn about hell, he said. Are you zooming in with the zoom?
Yep.
What are you showing?
No, I'm zooming in without the zoom, actually.
You better have good shots. If it's just you standing there, oh, I'm gonna fucking lose my mind. If I just look at this and you're just standing around.
Is that what you want me to zoom in on your fucking
this?
Fingers?
Yeah.
You can see that shit.
That's why you gotta zoom in on. I see my fingers. I see them.
I know. That's all you can see is fingers.
Yeah. Zoom close on them. What are my fingers doing?
Fingering.
No. They're fabricating, camera boy. My fingers are fabricating. Oh, shit, damn, hell, shit. He's looking tits. Oh, this is titillating. Come on out, you fucking glue. What in the hell is going on here? I had a malfunction of my tip. All right, there we go. Is that titillating or what? Are you going to show it? Thank you. Thank you, camera boy. Look, see that? Fabrication happened. You saw it here. Oh, shit liquor. Oh, these are going to be at a better angle than mine. I might have to steal them and switch them out. Oh, yeah. Oh, hell, brother. Oh, hell, we're going with it. We're fucking going with it, guys. It looks like we have a lot of depth. Because we're into here a little bit. But we could trim that back. It's still going to give us tweeter depth. Okay, now this is a very delicate process. If we snap the ring off again, I'm going to lose my fucking marble. My marble's going to lose. Oh, camera boy,
What color was it?
Clear? No. Purple? Okay, look, tape. We're going tape over this panel here. Are you filming?
No.
You're not?
I haven't been this whole time.
Okay, now you see how I'm shaping this? I'm not just sticking it on fucking dumb. Okay, some people swear by putting the tweeter up high. Yeah, you could do it that way too. There's more than one way to fucking put a tweeter in. This is a this is like an old school SQ thing. The problem with your tweeter up high is that the left tweeter is too close to your ear and the right tweeter is further away, causing a massive difference in distance from tweeter to ear. When you get them in the kick panel, the idea is you're getting the tweeter further forward. And the tweeter's fucking too loud to be right next to your head. How much tweet do you want to hear? How much tweet you need to be tweeting? You could time delay and stuff like that. But also, so say you have tweeters in your A-pillars. Go ahead and say it, everybody. Follow along. If you have tweeters in your A-pillars and you have it attenuated and time delayed so that both tweeters are the same loudness and the same delay with time delay. Time delay adjusts the difference of the tweeter. So if you have a tweeter close, or a difference of the speaker. So if you have a speaker close and one far, you can delay this one to make them sound like they're coming from equal distance away. But if you adjust that all to the driver's side, it sounds like shit on the passenger side. But if you get everything far forward and you just fucking put it in and tune it nice, not too much, not overly tuned, you could have yourself a swell outcome. Bob Morrow used to come in with a demo vehicle for whatever company he was repping, and it would sound so good, so we would like sign up and buy that stereo equipment. And they'd leave and go to a different company, and he'd show up with a different demo vehicle, different equipment, and it would sound better than the last one. It's like, oh shit, I wanted to, this is the best. He could make a dog turd sound good, which is the opposite of Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd. He can make good equipment sound like turd. But that's kind of where I learned, like, you should be able to make anything sound good. Okay, get back here, why don't you? Take a look at what we're doing here. How am I even supposed to? I don't know what you're supposed to do, camera boy. Man, what? This is what the... I don't understand the struggles you've been through.
Hold it like dick and then
I'm going to be rotating it and gluing it. Okay, that's why I bought you a gimbal.
What?
It's not yours. It's mine. I bought me a gimbal. But that's why I let you use a gimbal. So you can rotate it around when I'm rotating. Rotating unit. I'm using JB Weld plastic bonder. Oh, baby. Oh, no. I got glue on the ring, on the outer. Yeah, get in there, camera boy. Now, what this is going to do is give me a shape. I'm epoxying all the way around. The tape is preventing it from going all out the front. I just realized this is going to take a long time for this glue to dry, so we're going to have to sit here for 2 hours. Do you have enough time for that? Look at that, guys. Look at inside. Look it in there, camera boy. Yeah, look. See the goo? The goo is in there, guys. Look through the back. Ooh, the goo. So what's going to happen is we're going to peel this tape off, and it's going to reveal a shape.
I may need to trim this from the back to allow the tweeter to fit. So what we'll do is get the tweeter fitting in there good next, trim out what we need along the back, patch up whatever traumatization that causes. Okay, cool. There it is. Step one of the tweet ski. Now this one is at a similar angle-o. So we'll just go off, I'll mock this one up off of this one and test fit it. I might have adjusted that angle to be, they might be different. They might be non-symmetrical, asymmetrical, like your mama's tit jubblies. Titty McJubblies. What are we in?
35.
A short one, eh? Well, may as well cut out this other fucking side real quick. No need to fucking end this now. All right, let me get a measuring device. I don't want to like fuck up. So I'm going to measure. I'm going to measure. What are you burping into the microphone?
I don't even have a microphone.
That's about 1 inch away from the edge. And then we got three quarters of an inch from the bottom. The bottom. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. Shit, howdy. Let's give her a lopidocious. A lopidectomy. See that? It instantly stopped. Oh no, this is dangerous. Oh yeah, wow. That's not the right tool for the job. Go a little higher. Shit, howdy, brother. Oh, this has got a bunch of bullshit on it. Ooh, that's gonna be swell. That is going to be so swell. What the hell? That's quite a small tool we have here. Get a close-up on that little ring there, hmm? Look at that hardware. Tiny-ass hardware. Did it come with a tool? Didn't come with a tool. Oh, shit. What kind of dick is that, huh? What kind of bull dick? You gotta be bull dicking me. Do I have a little tiny set like that, huh? Huh? Oh no! I have it. You gotta be bull dicking me. Oh, these are torquies. I think a torque will fit in there. Will a torque fit? If a torque will fit, you must acquit. Shout out to O.J. Simpson. Oh no, I dropped this fucking expensive audio frog screw. Are you getting in a close up a super micro macro shot? Oh, did you get a shot of it falling? Mm-hmm. That's good. Are you getting a shot of this one? Oh, there you go. There. Are you getting a shot of this one?
No.
No. Why not, camera boy? Camera boy, you're in big trouble, pal. You are in big fat trouble, mister. Let's go on over to here. And I'm going to fabricate this into this fashion. Oh, come on, glue. I grabbed the Gorilla Glue with my mouth. What are you touching? What are you touching, camera boy? The zoom lens? Ugh. This is going to be it right here. Oh, horny bitch, horny, horny bitch, horny. Okay, now we got to stilt that up again like the other one. I don't want to let it move too much. Okay, I'm going to cut an identical stilt from the last one out of by memory. Oh, I bent it. I fashioned a bend into her. It's not quite perfect. It needs a little trimadocious. Ooh. Okay, let's check out the heights. Right under half an inch. Oh, bitch, dude. The bitch, dude. Bitch, dude. Let me tell you, bitch. We're on to something. We are on to something. I don't know what it is, but we're on to something. There you go, camera boy. That's what I want to see.
That's what I've been doing the whole time, bud.
No, you haven't. You have not.
Yeah.
This CA glue is available on my Amazon fabrication store at amazon.soundman.co. We have a plethora of fabrication goodies for you. Best deals on template tape, routers, router lift. Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd, put out a video. The new best car audio router, and it's a Bosch router. I'm like, bitch, I've been using that for fucking 20 years. He's been stuck on those cheap ass Porter cable turds. What a fucking... copied me again. Can't stand it anymore! Let's take a look and put this in here, huh? Get a shot from that side, and I'm gonna come in this side. You can be on that side getting in with the zoom. Oh. I would say that's fucking money sauce. I think these are both gonna be better than mine because it kind of tilts them out a little bit. Mine need to go, this one needs to go up. They sound fine though. That one did end up a little flat. Let me sit on that side real quick so I could get a... see what kind of shot we got going on over here. Some people aim the tweeters to the center of the headliner. Some people aim the right tweeter at the left ear and the left tweeter at the right ear. I think it's kind of better if you just kind of go to the middle of the headliner or in the front of the headliner, the front middle, and kind of adjust it for both sides, adjust it for the front, you know? It's not always good to like over tune the stereo with that time delay and all the bullshit. Okay, I'm gonna go this way a little bit, so look how we're gonna do this. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna removulate this piece. The bottom popped loose on us. My tip is dirty. And we're gonna go like this. Oh. That's just a little too far. Aiming a little too sidewards. That's a little better. We don't want her to go wonky on us. Ooh. Okay. Double check this real quick. Oh. That's good. That is good. You know, the old school stereo, car stereo concepts come from car, or come from home audio. Where the, you got a front stage in front of you, a right and a left. And a subwoofer. And an AB class amplification system. Ooh, shit! The hot rod shop I do work for, they're usually using coaxials with aimable tweeter. I think Morel makes a set. So you can achieve the same type of thing. Mount a coaxial in the kick panel and then aim the tweeter up. I gotta not press too hard as to crack the glue. Ooh, this might be good because if I lay this, we might have a... the other one might be dry enough to pull the tape off. Horny bitch! Remember the old school Q-Logic kick panels that would put a set of components in the kick panel? Those are kind of nice. You don't have a lot of room for your mid-bass. That's what I like, dude. The best sounding stereo I heard was when Bob Morrow came to my dad's old shop with the hybrid audio demo car. He had a set of L3 3-inch speakers that play up to 17,000 hertz, 17 kilohertz,
And then he had a L6, which is a big mid-bass driver, in the door. And he had the 3-inch playing all the way up, so it'd give you all the vocals and the tweeter range. And he had that aimed at you in the kick panel. So we had a right and left 3-inch, kind of a full range. I don't know what you would call that. I don't know what he had the low end of it crossed over at, but that's why I have the Ligatias and the Mule. We ended up carrying in hybrid audio. I was like, oh, that sounds great. Sign me up. Sign my dad up. Dad, write him a check. These are great. Can I get a set for my car? But that's the way to do it, because the tweeters kind of split the vocal range. So if you have a tweeter up high and a mid down low, you could hear some of the vocals coming out of the tweeter and some coming out of the mid. Which sounds like poop, if you ask me. But man, that demo car sounded so good. Any of you stereo guys met Bob Morrow before? He passed away recently. R.I.P. Bob. He was a cool dude. Last I talked to him, he was working with ARC. All right, glue in the back of her. He was my car stereo hero. I think when he was the first rep to have Hertz, oh, was it Red Mountain Audio? Or Hertz and Audison were being distributed by different companies for some reason back then. One of them was Red Mountain Audio, and they had the Denon deck back in the day. Ooh-wee. I think we used to get Nakamichi from them. That Nakamichi car stereo stuff was so good. That 6-disc changer that used to jam up all the time. They had an in-dash single din 6-disc. Wrap your head around that. I had that in my Acura. It was a single din, nice looking black radio with a knob and a display, just super simple. But you could jam 6 discs in her face. In her single din face. Shit, howdy, do you believe that, brother? But man, they used to jam all the time. So I had one in my Acura. I just used to fucking rock that thing. It sounded so good. And then ship it out when it jammed. Fuck it. Send her back to Japan. Japan! All right, what do you think about that? You little jackalope. You little son of a jackalope. I'm just going to kind of smear it around a little bit. Pull it away from the edge. I don't want it to go over the lip. So we'll grind these up, make the tweeters fit them. I just want to get enough glue on there to where it stays together. Then we'll make the tweeters fit, reinforce it. Reinforce in it. Shout out to Frogs. All right. I'm just going to let that one sit like this. All right, we'll go back over here. Think it's dry enough? Ooh, it's still kind of gooey. Look. Oh, bitch. That's just like was laying on the glue or tape. But there's still glue back there. Oh, yeah, I did you a set of little tweeter pods like this, too. There you go, look at that. That's a start to a pod if I've ever seen one. That's all grabbed on tight, baby. Oh, you know what I have to fix is my dust shoe. Get a shot of that. Why don't you? I need to fix my dust shoe. It broke on me, guys. This is a magnetic dust shoe for the CNC router. I modified the back of it because it doesn't fit. Check out the back of this sucker. She's got a steel back plate to her. Shit howdy. Shit howdy, brother. All right, look at that. All right. Okay, we'll let that dry, huh? How's that gonna dry? Needs to go like this. Oh yeah. On her back knees. Give her a lay on the back knees. Injecting extraneous glue. This sucker's really got a stick now. I can't be having her falling apart. Okay, that's good. We'll let that dry. Save this tube. We got a little bit of glue in there. It fell on the floor. Now I'm going to get it on my shoe and it's going to stick. And I'm going to get glue on my Subaru pedal. It's going to devalue the vehicle. All right, that's a step one of tweeter pod fabrication by the T-Bird. I really just want to like fucking sell the deep T-Bird, finish the mule, sell the mule, focus on the base van. And when the base van's done, we'll build the ultimate Chevy. Shit. Shit, howdy, brother. Give me a noise. Camera boy. Make a noise. He made a noise.
Purchase industry-leading iPad dash kits from the originator at soundman.co. Your car deserves the best. Update your car with an iPad dash kit from soundman.co. Find high-quality car audio gear at nvx.com. NVX is committed to audio quality and innovation. Their high-end car audio components are rated accurately, and they've been proven to perform since 2011. Try NVX at nvx.com.